The deserts of the Colorado Plateau are full of dangers. A dry landscape, the lack of water limits life and can threaten any human that enters this wilderness. A small creek of water flowing through a canyon may seem like a pleasant escape from the dangers of dehydration and the heat. But here, there are new dangers. On occasion, thunderstorms miles away can trigger flash floods that turn quiet creeks into deadly torrents, able to uproot trees. And what appears to be a stable sandy creek bed could easily give way beneath your feet, because it is quicksand. So what is quicksand exactly? Well, it's loose sand suspended in water. There are two main ways this occurs. Artisanal quicksand is created by water bubbling up from the ground, keeping the sand in motion, like these turbulent quicksand patches at the bottom of this geothermal lake. And then there is quicksand that forms in standing water. Sand particles form into a lattice-like structure with the space in between filled with water. This configuration of sand particles makes these quicksands a non-Newtonian fluid, which means force exerted on it changes its viscosity. Undisturbed, it behaves like a solid and appears as such. However, a change, such as the pressure of a foot, will cause the material to radically change. The lattice structure collapses like a house of cards under the pressure, sinking quickly below your feet. The physics involved with quicksand is really cool and, frankly, magical. This small creek has only a few centimeters of quicksand above its bedrock, and is not a spectacular example of what quicksand can be. The deeper sand bed of a wide wash is a far better place to find the more impressive stuff. In this overhang of a canyon wall, standing water has allowed part of the sand bed to become quicksand, which can engulf a person nearly to their waist. In the deepest quagmires, a person will only sink a little further, maybe up to their armpits, but no further. The human body is less dense than quicksand and so will float, unable to get sucked under. That, however, does not mean that quicksand isn't dangerous. The forces created by quicksand are incredibly powerful. To pull a human limb directly out of quicksand would take some 100,000 newtons of force, which is what is required to lift a car. The issue is, after acting like a liquid, the sand becomes very viscous as dense sand forms around your feet. If someone were to become stuck, it would leave them trapped and exposed to the elements. Predators, the scorching sun, dehydration, hypothermia, and flash floods could all quickly kill a trapped person out here, so escaping quicksand promptly and in the right way is imperative. The key is to reintroduce some of the water into the sand by creating a gap between your legs and the sand by moving back and forth, then slowly and deliberately working your way out. Quicksand was once a staple of film and entertainment, but with a wider understanding of how it doesn't suck hapless victims under its surface, it has lost some of that cinematic magic and threat it once had. However, quicksand is such a neat material with such unique physical properties, it is a case where something once viewed with fear, with the help of science, can now be viewed as a beautiful natural phenomenon.
Just run for it. Oh, she's sunk in. Whoa! Oh, God. I just had to. Whoa!